Hey everyone, it's Justine. Welcome to day 8 of the 12 Days of Christmas series. Today we are going to focus on cards that are mainly used with die cuts, so they're really easy to mass produce and you can just glue them all together and get ready to go. Today's cards are going to focus on layering and getting gorgeous layers with beautiful Christmas colors in an elegant gold and white. So let's get started. So today's cards are all about building layers. I created these two here, and I started off by grabbing some washi tape from Birch Press Designs. I ended up choosing the one with the sort of star pattern because it matches all the layering dies that I'm going to be using today. So I grabbed a piece of the washi tape. If you've watched my channel, you know I love oversized washi tape. I was very intrigued by this because when I pulled it out, it was quite transparent. So I decided to not just do a standard white background, but also to try it on black to see what it was going to look like. So once you have the washi tape, you tear it off, you can just fold those panels there behind your cardstock or trim them with some scissors. Using the black one, I found I had to go over with a bone folder just to get that black to really show through and to push really hard on the washi tape. Well, I wasn't pushing really hard, I just needed some additional pressure. So I'm also going to be using these bevel plate layer dies. These are mini ones, so these aren't a size of a card panel, but rather slightly smaller. It's a little bit friendlier on the budget for these types of layering dies when they're not that full size, and I absolutely love the way that they look. I'm going to be die cutting these in white holographic and harvest gold cardstock. So when you're all finished die cutting these, you have these three panels here that all you need to do is layer them one on top of the other. Because of the same size, it works out quite well and it's pretty easy to glue them down. It's a really great way to create a focal point in a background, and I love the way that holographic cardstock really just works. So once I glued them all, they were all on this background pattern. So I hope it's okay that I skipped the gluing. I just didn't want to bore anyone to tears. I'm going to be using the Fa-la-la-la Honey Script die. This comes with a shadow die as well as the lettering. I die cut that in harvest gold as well as black satin cardstock, a little bit different than your standard black cardstock, because I wanted to keep things really shiny and smooth for this card since the background contains that type of cardstock as well. So I went ahead and added my Nouveau Deluxe Liquid Adhesive to my sentiment, and then I was able to line it up on the black background. What I think I love most about creating cards like this is you can do this type of thing in front of the couch. It's just die cuts all layered on top of each other pretty much, so they're really easy to create. If you have a die cutting machine that fits, you know, like the 8.5 by 11 Gemini, you could literally die cut everything for this card in one shot, make it super quick and easy. And of course, with the Gemini, these fine detailed dies just cut like butter and you don't have to worry about, you know, popping them out or anything like that. So that black background really, really makes everything pop, I think. It makes the sentiment really stand out because the background is quite busy. It's got a lot of shine, a lot of gold. It seems that my cards this year, I find every time I do this holiday series, I end up sticking with a color theme, like whether it be the traditional red and green, or sometimes it's blue, blue and silver. And this year seems to be white and gold, I seem to be really obsessed with. So this card I absolutely loved when it was finished. I have to say, when I was making it, I kept getting skeptical and more skeptical because I thought it wasn't turning out the way that I had in my mind. But overall, I really love all the layers and dimension on this card. I think it's absolutely stunning. Now for the second card, as you can see here, I'm finished with the first one. I'll give you another quick look at that, all the beautiful details with that holographic paper. You can really see how that holographic paper just hits the light. My favorite type of cardstock to use right now. I've gone ahead and die cut the same color combination. This time I'm using the Mini Grandiose Bevel Plate Layer. It has the same type of pattern as the first one, but it's obviously a lot thinner. It's only about 1¼ inches or so wide versus the mini one, which has covered a good portion of my card background. Once again, I am just lining these up one on top of the other exactly like I would have and showing you in a little bit more detail. So the layers come in A, B, and C, and that's exactly how you glue it. You glue A on top of B on top of C, and the thinnest one goes on top and the thickest one goes on the bottom. You'll see less and less detail with the layering dies as you go along. So Birch Press Design really make those quite well. I absolutely love all the beautiful layers that they come up with. I've gone ahead now, and this time I added the black panel onto my card base. So again, the same washi tape as the first card, except for it's on black. And then the same type of die, so it's the same pattern, except smaller. So this is just a nice variation. This one's a little bit more friendly on the budget since the die cuts are smaller. And both of them, I think, look really great in the end. And I like the fact that this washi tape really can be quite versatile depending on the type of cardstock you add it to. I could totally see myself adding it to like a dark purple or a dark pink, and I think it would look just as elegant. So I've gone ahead and added that to the left side, the layering dies, and this time I've added the word peace. This is the Peace Honey Script die from Birch Press, and I'm adding that to the shadow die, again, harvest gold and black satin. And this time, though, because the layering, I only have the sentiment layering on top of the layering dies on the left, I ended up having to use a 3D foam tape to stabilize the E, because it wasn't just going to lie flat because this is so elevated. So you get a lot of dimension in these layering cards, and I absolutely love them. I'm on the Birch Press design team, so I always have a video, you know, about once a month featuring the products. So if you enjoy them and you enjoy that company, definitely tune in to all those videos because they make literally the most gorgeous dies. And no shock, I mean, they belong to Memory Box, and you know, their dies are also really fantastic. So I hope you enjoyed this video. We made these two pretty quick and easy cards, just some simple die cutting and adding some washi tape. You could obviously replace the washi tape with patterned paper if you wanted to make it even easier. And here is a close-up of each of those. Thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to check out the other few days that have already gone by of the 12 Days of Christmas series, and be sure to subscribe to the channel and check out my suggested video below. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.